Hello, dear students. Today we will take another subtitle of the lesson. Matter in our surroundings is boiling. Boiling. When we heat any substance, or you can say water, liquid substance. The particles in the water, they get more kinetic energy, and these particles, they move more freely, or you can say with more speed. And we continuously heat the liquid substance until the liquid gets boiled. At a particular temperature, the temperature at which the boiling occurs, or you can say the particular temperature at which boiling occurs, it is known as boiling point of that liquid. If we say water has boiling point of 100 degrees Celsius, and due to this quality, that means boiling point, you can separate different types of substances, liquid substances, because every liquid have particular boiling point. It is the main quality, physical property at which you can separate different types of liquids. We will see this in another lesson. And another is sublimation. Sublimation. Or you can say vaporization. When we continuously heat the liquid, at boiling point, the vapor or the liquid changes into vapors, and this process is known as vaporization. At that point, for example, if we continuously heat this vessel, water containing vessel, the water present on the surface, they get most heat, or you can say the heat overcomes the force of attraction between the water molecules, and these water molecules leave as vapors. And the amount of heat required to change 1 kilogram of liquid to vapors is known as latent heat of vaporization. What does it mean? When we heat this liquid substance, the heat overcomes the force of attraction between the two water molecules. This is the water molecule. These water molecules are attracted to each other with the help of hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bonds are like this. If I draw the structure of this, it is the oxygen molecule. These are hydrogen. This is hydrogen atom. Two hydrogen atoms. This is the structure of water molecule. And another water molecule is like this. These water molecules are attracted towards each other by hydrogen bonding. This hydrogen bonding, when we heat the water, the heat overcome the force of when we heat the water, this force of attraction is overcome by heat, and with the result the water evaporates or the water molecule gets into vapors. This vaporization or the vapors accumulate more heat than the water. That is why the burns caused by the steam, they are more dangerous than the hot water, because when we continuously heat the water, the thermometer reading will stop at 100 degree centigrade. If you continuously heat the vessel again and again and again, the temperature will not rise, but the vapors will evolve more and more. The heat, where does the heat go, which we continuously supplied this vessel, the heat actually gets stored in the steam. That steam is having more power than the hot water, because hot water is having some little amount of heat stored in it, but the steam is having more amount of heat stored in it. That is why the burners of the steam, they are more dangerous than the hot water burners, because in steam there is latent heat, that means hidden heat. What is the latent heat of fusion? It is the hidden heat of vaporization. The definition is that the amount of heat required to change 1 kilogram of liquid, 1 kilogram of liquid to its vapors, the amount of heat required to change 1 kilogram of liquid to its vapors. This is known as latent heat of vaporization, and this latent heat of vaporization allows the steam to do more work, because it stores more heat. Steam has more heat than hot water. Thank you. Have a nice day.